हेलो हेलो ओके नाउ दिस इज न्यूमेरिकल्स बेस्ड ऑन द बैंकर्स एल्गोरिथम्स. नाउ वी यूज दिस न्यूमेरिकल्स फॉर चेकिंग आवर सिस्टम इज इन सेफ स्टेट और नॉट. वी हैव नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेसेस, एलोकेशंस, मैक्सिमम एलोकेशन एंड अवेलेबिलिटी. वी हैव प्रोसेस P0, allocation of P0 is 0 instance of type A, 1 instance of type B and 0 instance of type C. The maximum allocation 7 instance of type A resource, 5 instance of type B resource and 3 instance of type C resource. Availability, we have 3 instance of type A resource, 3 instance of type B resource and 2 resource of type C. In the same way, process P1 have allocation 2, 0, 0. Maximum is 3, 2, 2. Availability always be same and it may be changed after the execution of process. P2 3 0 2 9 0 2 process P3 2 1 1 2 2 2 process P4 0 0 2 4 3 3 okay. That will be given by the numerical processes, allocation, maximum and availability. Now to make solve this type of questions, we should start with the need. First we have to find out the need. So first we will find need as per our formula, that is need equal to maximum allocation minus allocation. So here is maximum allocation, you can find it in the allocation block. 0 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 0, 3 to 5 plus 2 7, A type 7 resources we have. Let's write it. Maximum is A, B, C and the maximum resource of type A is 3 plus 2 plus 2, 7. B is 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1 plus 0, that is 2. We have 2 instances of type B and the C is 2 plus 1 plus 2, 2 plus 1 plus 2, 5. We have 5 instances of type C. Right. Start calculating the need of process P0 equal to maximum we have 7 to 5, subtract it from the allocation of P0, that is 0 1 0. Okay. We have maximum is 7 to 5. Okay, let's calculate it. This is maximum allocation we have already given. 7 minus 0, 5 minus 1, 3 minus 0. That is the way of calculating the need, maximum minus allocation. We will drop these terms right now so that we have already column of maximum allocation. So calculate from here. 7, 5, 3 minus 0, 1, 0. That is 7 minus 0, 7 minus 0 equal to 7, 5 minus 1 equal to 4, 3 minus 0 equal to 3. In the same way, process P1, need equal to 3, 2, 2, 3 minus 2, that is 1. Maximum allocation of process P1 is 3, 2, 2 minus 2, 0, 0 is equal to 3 minus 2, 1, 2 minus 0, 2, 2 minus 0 is 2. In the same way, you can calculate as P2 is equal to 9, 0, 2 minus 3, 0, 2 is equal to 9 minus 3, that is 6, 0 minus 0, that is 0, 2 minus 2, that is 0. Next, P3 is equal to P3, maximum allocation is 222 minus 211, that is allocation, is equal to 2 minus 2, that is 0, 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. Calculate the last process P4. The need of process P4 is the maximum allocation of process P4 is 433 minus 002 is equal to 4 minus 0, that is 4, 3 minus 0, that is 3, and 3 minus 2, that is 1. Okay, we have need of all the process. Now we start the executions of first process. First we will take process P0 for execution. P0 for execution. Okay, we also initialize vector one, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 process, right? Vector 1, vector 2, vector 3, vector 4, vector 5. Right, so let's start from the vector 0 because we have process P0, and start from the 4. We can also take all the vector initialize with the 0, and that will be set by 1 if the process gets terminated after the execution. So let's be initialize all the vectors from the 0. So 5 times 0. Right. Now the basic need is, the first way to calculate is okay, calculate the need, process P0. First we will start from the process P0. Need of process P0 equal to 743. If need is less than equal to available, That means the NIRA process is 743 is less than equal to available, and we have process 332, that is availability 332. So 743, we required 7 instances of type A, but we have 3 instances of type A. We required 4 instances of type B resource, but we have only 3 instances of type B. So first and second and third condition will not satisfy the request. We have limited number of resources of type A, B, C, and we required much resource type A, B, C. In that case, the need is not less than equal to availability, so we will not start execution of process P0, and process will go on waiting queue for further execution. And also vector 0 would not set by 1, right? If the process P0 gets executed, then we set the vector, otherwise we will not. Okay, step first for the process P0, right? Step 2 for process P1, let's calculate. Need always be less than equal to availability. What is the need of process P1? We have 122. 122 is less than equal to availability is 332, right? We required 1 instance of type A, and we have 3 instance of type A, right? We required 2 instance of type B, we have 3 instance of type B. In the same way, we have required 2 instance of type A, we have 2 instance of type C. So there is condition true. The need is less than equal to available. The need of process is less than equal to the availability of the resources. So we can allocate two resources to process P1. Now we start allocation of type A, B, C to process P1 resources to process P1 and execution will start. After execution, process P1 will release resources. And how much resources it will release? Released resources by process P1 is equal to allocation is 200 two resource of type A, 0 of type B, and 0 of type C. So it will release the resources 200 regarding type A, B, C respectively. Okay, so released resources by P1 is 200. So after execution, the released resources will be add on with the availability. So we have available resources plus released resources. Available resources we have 332 plus released resources is equal to 200. Finally, we have 3 plus 2, 5 instance of type A resource, 3 plus 0, 3 resource instance of type B, and we have 2 resource of type type C. So currently available resource is equal to 532. Now we will consider that resource availability for the next process. That is important point. We will not consider 332. We will not consider that availability because process P1 gets executed. It is now terminated and release the resources. Whatever the resources it has, now the release resources will be add on to the availability, and we have greater number of resources of type A, B, C respectively. Right? Now calculate the process. Okay, the point is to be remembered that if the process gets terminated, you should set the vector. So in the case of vector P1, that is the second vector should be set by 1. Right, vector that is 0 for P0, 1 for P1, and the rest of 0, because that will not getting the chance for execution. So step 3. Now for the process P2, need is less than equal to available. The need of process P3, let's P2, need is 600. Okay, so need of process P3 is 600 is less than equal to availability of resources is currently 532. 6 is greater than 5, that means we will not consider it. Okay, about the execution, process P1 P2 will go on waiting queue. Okay, and the vector will not set. Vector will not set by 1. Okay, now step 4 for the process P3, need is less than equal to available. Okay, process P3, the need of process P3 is 011, that is the need 011 is less than equal to 532. So here you can see 0 is less than to 5, 1 is less than to 3, and 1 is less than to 2. In that case, the process gets executed by the CPU. Okay, process P3 gets chance to execute, and after execution it will again released our resources. Whatever the resources the process P3 have, it start releasing the resources. And if process release the resources, the released resources will add on availability. Right? So we have greater amount of available resources. So let's calculate how much resources it release. So we have to consider the allocation of P3. allocation of P3, allocation of P3, that is the process P3, allocation is 211. Okay. So maximum allocation is 211. So released resources by P3 is 211 will be add on current availability, that is 532, and total number of resources we have right now 2 plus 5, that is 7, 3 plus 1, that is 4, and 2 plus 1 is 3. Right, so currently we have 7, 4, 3 resources of types A, B, C. Right, so 7 instances of type A, 4 instances of type B, and 3 instances of type C. Okay, now set the vector. Now set the vector 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Process P0 could not get chance to execute, that's why P0 is set to 0. P1 gets chance to execute, that is why P1 set 0 from 0 to 1. P2 again will not get chance to execute, that is why it is again set by 0. P3 gets chance, so we set P3 equal to 1, and P4 not process yet. So let's start again step 5 for process P4. Need is less than equal to available. Now calculate the need from the table. Need of process P4 is 431. 431, that is the need of process P4 is less than equal to available. Available currently we have 743. 743, and it is less than equal to available. 4 is less than equal to 7, yes. 3 is less than equal to 4, yes. And 1 is less than equal to 3. Right, we can consider the process P4 for execution. We can execute process P4, and after execution process P4 releases resources. So how many resources it released? Let's calculate. Released resources by process P4 released resources by P4 is, now calculate again, allocated resource will be released, that is the allocation. So 002, that much resource will be released by the process P4. 002 equal to 002, that will be add on with our current availability. So 743. Now currently we have 7, 4 and 5. Right, that much resource we currently have. Now currently we have 7, 4, 5 resources of type A, B, C. Now set the vector for process P4. So 0, 1, 0, 1 and 1. Now come to the process again P0, because P0 due to high demand, due to its high requirement, it had not executed by the CPU. But let's check again, maybe we have greater number of resources in availability, so maybe it get chance to execute. So step 6 for process P0, let's consider it. Need is less than equal to availability. The process P0, need of process P0 is 753 is less than equal to 745, that is our current availability 745, and the need of process P0 is 753. Now we can consider the process P0. As you can see here, we required 7 instances of type A. We have 7 instances of type A. We can consider it 5, 4. In the second, right, we cannot calculate the process P0 due to second instances. We have lack amount of resources. We required 5 instances of type B, but we have 4 instances of type B. Right. Again, it will not following by the process P0. So it will not consider for execution. Again, it will stay on waiting queue. It will not consider for execution, and again it will stay on waiting queue. Okay, calculate the rest of process. Rest, I mean to say that the process is P0 again not getting the chance for execution due to high demand, due to high requirement. 1 already terminated. P0, P1, P2. Let's start with the P2 for process P2. Need is less than equal to available. Need of process P2 600 is less than equal to available is 745. Let's check it. 6 is less than to 7, yes. 0 is less than to 4, yes. And 0 is less than to 5, yes. We can consider it. We can consider it for execution. We can consider it to it for execution. After execution, process P2 release the resources. Now how much it will release the resources, let's calculate it. Process P2 allocation is 302. That much resources will be released after the execution of process P2, and release resources will add on to the availability. So 302. Okay. 302 plus currently we have 745. Now 10, 4, 10, 4 and 7. That much resources currently we have. 7 plus 3, 0 plus 4 and 2 plus 5. Now currently we have A type, 10 instances of type A, 4 instances of type B and 7 instances of type C. Of types A, B, C. Right, now we have greater availability, so we can consider the problem of process P1 in the next step, 8. for process P0. Need, okay, for execution, after execution we should set vector, set vector 0 1 1 1 1. Except process P0, all the process gets terminated. Now process P0 needs is less than equal to available. Need is process P0, we can consider from here 753. Okay, 753 is less than equal to 1047 availability. We have 10 instances of type A, we have 4 instances of type B and 7 instances of type C. Now calculate, 7 is less than to 10, yes, 5 is less than to 4 and 3 is less than to 7, right. We can start, execution of process P0. After execution, process P0 will release resources. Okay, how much resources it will release? Let's calculate. P0, the allocation is 010. 010 it will add on with the total availability, that is 1047 in our case. So 10 plus 0 is 10, 1 plus 4 that is 5, and 0 plus 7 that is 7. Right. So currently we have 10, 5, 7 resources of type A, B and C. So we have completed our execution with respect to 5 processes. Now we got the order, and the order is P0. Now first we will set the process P2, P1, P1, then it will not set P1, then P3, P1, P3, P4, P1, P3, P4, then P2 and then P0. That is the order. So order of executions of processes, that is P1, P3, P4, P2 and then last P0. That is very important guys. If we should not, if we will not follow that order or a sequence of execution of the process, maybe our system is in deadlock. It will not in the safe state. We should follow the same sequences. First we should execute the process P1, then go on process P3, then P4, P2 and so on. Right? If we follow the same order, P0 and P1 and P2 and P3 and P4, definitely our system will is in safe, unsafe state. Right? So that is the order. It tells us the execution of process P1, P3, P4, P2 and P0. Okay, now this sequence also tells that sequence also tells us that that sequence also tells us that if we follow if we follow that particular order, definitely our system will remain in safe state. That is why this algorithm used for checking the system is in safe state or not.